Hi guys, I'm Chun-Tri, the VR enthusiast. Today, I'm gonna show you draw the lens and field of view I measured. Quest 2, Quest Pro, Reverb G2, and Varjo Aero. My draw the lens is not science. It's not a sophisticated way to compare lenses. Also, it is hard to say that the screen on the video is a real VR experience. But you can get the relative difference of devices in this video to some extent. And I show you the FOV2. This is measured by the TESTHMD program. The FOV differs depending on the face type, so please refer to this as a relative reference for each device. Okay, so let's get into it. the lens quality of Quest Pro was quite impressive. Quest Pro has less resolution than Quest 2 on the spec sheet, and this is a bummer because it was released as a high-end device. However, I could feel and comprehend the increase in quality that Meta said in Connect 2022, and I could feel the decrease in Gunway and the increase in SwissPot. Quest Pro's color looks better than Reverb G2. I could feel vivid color and better blank level in Quest Pro 2. The best thing is that it has better edge-to-edge clarity, which means it has a bigger SwissPot and has considerable clarity. Why do I feel clearer than Quest 2? Even though the resolution is not much different. This is because Quest Pro has two display panels that apply to each eye. Quest 2 has only one panel and some pixels are wasted structurally. The Quest Pro reduced this waste by using two panels. Thus, it has a clearer screen about 37% higher, even though it was similar in resolution to Quest 2. Of course, due to the limitation of compression transmission loss, the native connection of Reverb G2 has a better clarity of the central area. If you look closely, you can see the noise in Quest Pro. However, the difference was not felt much personally, and Quest Pro made me feel a better experience via a wide sweet spot. In terms of clarity, it's hard to compare with Varjo Aero, but it was as good as Reverb G2. In addition to that, it provides considerable satisfaction with the excellent fit without facial compression. So, is Quest Pro a must-have device? It was better than I expected in most aspects except color pass-through. But the problem is the price. Considering the price, I personally don't think that it is a must-have device. On top of that, there is a rumor that there is an upcoming Quest 3 released in 2023 and Quest Pro 2 having an OLED panel released in 2024. In conclusion, if you have enough money in your pocket, the Quest Pro is a very satisfying device, and I recommend it. The price is a bit expensive though. Okay, that's all for today. I hope this video helped you. If you like this, subscribe please. The following device comparison video might be Pulse VR2. Still far from the release date of February 2023, but I'm really looking forward to it. Okay, let's wait together. See you next video.
구독 버튼 눌러야 된다.
구독 버튼?
구독 버튼 눌러야 된다.
이거?
아니, 여기 밑에 있는 건데 아빠가 못하니까 여기로 해야 돼, 알겠지?
그래? 띡 눌렀어요.
이제 여기만 띡 누르면 돼. 여기 세 개.
여기 세 개?
아니, 여기.
이건 무슨 버튼인데?
여기는 알람을 이렇게 아빠가 온 거를 알려주는 거예요. 여기 알람 꼭 눌러야 돼. 중요한 거예요.
알겠어. 중요하네. 띵 눌렀어요.